just look at you, girl, standing here beside me, starlight on your hair, looking like a dream I dreamed somewhere. And look at me, girl, you got me acting just like a lover in an old-time picture show. And how I got the part, I just don't know. But it's written all across your face, plain as it can be. You're the one that I was looking for. Now you're all that I can see. And you mean everything to me. And I'd do anything to have you stay forever. I'm an ordinary man, but I feel like I could do anything in the world. When I look at you, girl, just look at you, girl, walking here beside me in the misty morning light. I see my own reflection in your eyes, and you smile at me, girl, with eyes that tell a story that words could never say, telling me your love is gonna stay. And we're standing right together now in everything we do. And if my world should come apart, I'll still be loving you. 'Cause you mean everything to me. And I'd do anything to have you stay forever. I'm an ordinary man, feel like I could do anything in the world. When I look at you, girl,
cry, be sure to dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. And when you smile, be sure to smile wide, and don't let them know that they have won. And when you walk, walk with pride, don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone. When you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. When you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big. And when you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, 'cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see, see the beauty all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray and pray for strength, it's to help you carry on. And when the troubles come your way, and when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean. When you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big. you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see the beauty all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray for strength to help you carry on, and when the troubles come your way. And when you dream big, as big as the ocean blue. Cause when you dream, it might come true. When you dream big.
Life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by,
was grace that taught my blind, but now I see.
Tell your old man you'll do some largemouth fish in another town. You just got too much on your plate to bait and cast the line. You can always put a rain check in his hand till you can't. You can keep putting off forever with that girl whose heart you hold, swearing that you'll last someday further down the road. You can always put a diamond on her hand till you can. If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can. There's a box of greasy parts sitting in the trunk of that 65, still waiting on you and your granddad to bring it back to life. You can always get around to fixing up that Pontiac till you can't.
Chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can.
So take that phone call from your mama and just talk away. You'll never know how bad you wanna till you can't someday. Don't wait on tomorrow, 'cause tomorrow may not show. Say your sorries, your I love yous, 'cause man, you never know.
If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. You're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can till you can. Yeah, if you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it, 'cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can until you can.
If we could at this time, let's have everyone stand as the family makes their way in.
Right. can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees?
Be seated. Well, just take a moment. Just take a moment and look around. Take a moment and look around, and you're going to see what faith looks like, what hope looks like, and above all, love. Paul tells us the greatest of these is love. This room is full of it. He first loved us. Jamie's love touched all of you. And just look around. If you're confused about your purpose in life, clarity is right before you today. It's God and His love. Thank you all for being here. The scriptures tells us in Galatians chapter 6, verse 2, it's a beautiful summary of the gospel of Jesus, and it says this: carry each other's burdens, and in this way you fulfill the law of Christ. And that's what we're here today. We're here to carry the burden, burdens of the Epperson family and the Reeve family, and for all of you who are grieving so deeply today. We're all here for you, and we're here for one another, and we're here to give glory to God and to celebrate an amazing life. It's no accident why we're all here today. And we just want to give God glory and praise, and we want to celebrate Jamie's life today. So that's what we're going to do. If you would, let's join together in prayer. Father God, I welcome you. I welcome you into this place. Let your spirit move. Let your love abound. Let the kindness that comes only through you fill the hearts and the minds of this of everyone here as we grieve our loss. And it is our loss, Father. It is our loss. But it is Jamie's gain. And we are so grateful. So heal hearts today, Father. Bless us all as we celebrate a life well lived. And Father, I know Jamie would want this. It's all for your name's sake and glory. And in Jesus we pray. Amen. At this time, one of our dear friends, Kai Graham, Coach Graham's going to come up and lead us. We have two congregational songs today. I want to encourage, even if you don't know the song or even if you think you can't sing, let's just make a joyful noise to the Lord. So we encourage everyone to sing along with us.
Victory in Jesus. I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary
to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his growth, he is built for me in glory, and I heard about the streets of gold. Beyond the crystal sea, about the angels singing, and the old redemption story, and some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood.
Thank you.
Now, Jamie Epperson was a sister in Christ. Zan and I first met Jamie when we came to Eastside as 27 years ago. And my wife and I saw Jamie and her family very often. We enjoyed being with each other, and I enjoyed teaching Jamie when to cut the roses and how to have a garden. One of my most fondest memories of her is we talked about that garden, and she said, I've spent all this time on fertilizer and water and soil to get this one cucumber. But you know, Jamie and her family are some of my wife and I's closest friends. Dr. Jamie Epperson was born in Amarillo on November 26, 1968, to Don and LaVon Reeve. Jamie is the youngest of three children. She married the love of her life and best friend, Casey Epperson, on August 21st, 2000, at Lake Tahoe, California. She was a devoted wife, a loving and caring mother, a dedicated dentist, a servant to our community, and a steadfast friend. Jamie Epperson graduated salutatorian from La Mesa High School, and then after working in a dentist office while she was in high school, she decided that she wanted that to be her lifelong vocation. She graduated with honors from West Texas State University in 1991, and while in college, she was active in several student organizations and was even elected homecoming queen in 1990. Jamie soon began her studies at the University of Texas Health in San Antonio's School of Dentistry, where she also graduated with honors. Jamie was an active member of the American Student Dental Association, Texas Association of Women Dentists, Student Research Group, International Association of Dental Research. She received the American Dental Association Certificate of Merit for international service for traveling as a part of the dental team to Guatemala to provide dental care to the Quiche Indian population. She received awards for excellence in clinical dentistry and oral diagnosis. After graduating from dental school, she came to Graham in July 1995 and joined Dr. David Scott at the Austin Road Dental Clinic. When I went back and looked in the Graham papers, here's how Jamie introduced herself to Graham, Texas. Graham was my first choice when I was deciding where I wanted to practice. When I was younger, I and my family used to come to Possum Kingdom a lot, almost every summer, and I loved it. I've always thought the Graham was such a friendly, pretty town, and after being in San Antonio, I was ready to get out of the big city and come to a smaller community. In 2000, Jamie Epperson bought the practice, and in 2007, opened 12 Oaks Dental Clinic in Graham. Jamie had her dental practice here in Graham for 28 years. You know, she was my dentist, and I can't tell you how many times during a procedure she would ask these questions. Now tell me if it hurts. Another thing she would tell me is, are you okay? And I can remember so many times when I needed help outside of those office hours that, scary as it might be, Casey was her dental assistant on a Sunday afternoon. But you know, I never heard her say no. She always said yes. And I never said no to her. I always said yes. But especially, Casey, I want you to know, I am so thankful that Jamie introduced me to nitrous oxide. That first time she said, do you want gas? I said, I don't really know what that is. But after that, I always wanted it. But you know, being a dentist, sometimes a painful situation. But I want you to know, I always felt at ease with her. That was the person she was. She was a faithful member of the East Side Church of Christ. I want you to tell you, she loved this church. And she loved the church. She always talked about God. She talked about his influence in her life. And she believed everything was possible if Jesus was on your side. And I really think, Don LeVon, that was because of your influence on her life as a young child. Because she grew up that way. She understood that way. And something else I think about Jamie, her life, her smile, her involvement was proof that the Holy Spirit was alive and well in her life. Jamie spent her life serving others, never thinking of herself, always looking for ways to share random acts of kindness. Jamie participated in dental mission trips to Guatemala, Haiti, and Ecuador. In 2013, she created a running club for Woodland Elementary called Run for God to encourage kids to eat healthy and exercise. And I can be a testament, she even taught that class at Eastside. She taught Run for God. And I will still always remember the one Run for God that I participated in Breckenridge, Texas. Randy Andrews and I fought to be last, but we finished. And what was amazing about that was she was there at the finish line encouraging us on. Jamie wasn't an athlete in her youth, but grew to love running later for the peace and sense of achievement it gave her and the camaraderie with running with friends. She ran 5Ks, half marathons, and even one marathon. And Jamie felt that there was bound to be a way to make the running experience more meaningful. So Jamie was a spark plug behind the Spivey Hill Challenge 5K in Graham. You know, Jamie is a symbol of taking the challenge and fighting through it every step of the way. Since 2015, the Spivey Hill Challenge 5K has raised $96,000 and has benefited countless individuals in need of help. Hundreds of volunteers and runners have participated, and there's no way to calculate the love that has been shared through the seed of Jamie's idea. Our beloved Jamie Epperson passed away on July 14, 2023, in Wichita Falls, but that's not the end of her story. Jamie showed by her selfless example how to love one another, how to follow God, how to care for our neighbors, and how to raise a family. Jamie will be missed, but she will never be forgotten. Jamie Epperson was a gift to us all and will be sadly missed by her husband, Casey Epperson of Graham, her daughter, Emily Epperson, her son, Cody Epperson, both of Graham, her parents, Don and LaVon Reeve of Graham, her brother, J. Don Reeve, and wife, Rhonda of Athens, her sister, Julie Banfield, and husband, Kirk of Plano, four nieces, Brittany Hopkins, Ashley Bassnett, Macy Tenry, Taryn Banfield, and one nephew, Parker Banfield. Five great nieces and nephews, and a host of aunts, uncles, and cousins. So let me close by saying this. Dr. Jamie Epperson will be remembered because she touched so many lives. Her physical presence may not be with us, but her spirit remains within each of us. I think her life is just an example of who we all should be. Listen to the words of 1 Peter 4 from the Message. Everything in the world is about to be wrapped up, so take nothing for granted. Stay awake in prayer. Most of all, love each other as if your life depended on it. Love makes up for practically anything. Be quick to give a meal to the hungry, a bed to the homeless, cheerfully. Be generous with the different things that God gave you, passing them around so all can get in on it. If words, let it be God's word. If help, let it be God's hearty help. That way, God's bright presence will be evident in everything through Jesus, and he'll get all the credit as the one mighty in everything. Encores to the end of time. Oh, yes. Those are the words of a servant. Those are the words of Jamie Epperson.
There's a light that glows by the front door. Don't forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church 'cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. Won't be wasted time. Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. Why bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone you love. I love you ain't no pickup line, so always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When those dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself pride, but always stay humble and kind. Popsicle, shut off the AC and roll the windows down.
let that summer sun shine. Always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget, turn back around. Help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind.
I'd like to say, on behalf of me and my family, we are so thankful you are here for us and support us through this hard time. I know that you love my mom, and I know that my mom loved all of you. There is another thing that my mom loved. She loved it when I would read scripture at church, from the time I was just a little kid all the way up until now. It made her so happy and proud. So to honor her, I'm going to be reading her favorite scripture, 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18. Rejoice always, pray continuously, and give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Good morning. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Parker Banfield. I'm Julie's daughter and Jamie's nephew. My sister Taryn and I have a lot of fond memories of our Aunt Jamie over the years, whether it be a special occasion or run-of-the-mill typical day. Being with Jamie was always special because of the light and positivity she carried with her. The way she made others feel was special. It's something that's difficult to describe with words, but I think my cousin Brittany did a pretty great job. And I'm thankful that she's allowed me to share these words with you today. Although the memories are not my own, I can feel Jamie through them, and I hope all of you can too. Some of my earliest memories are with my Aunt Jamie, from learning the Pee Wee Herman dance, to singing the WT fight song, to playing the Guess the Song in the car for a nickel or a dime. She was always there. When I got a little older, it was one weekend every 3 months. I got to choose whatever I wanted to do with her, and we would do it. From Dave and Buster's to renting movies and spending the weekend at the lake house, she was always there. From her being there for my entire childhood to every Thanksgiving, playing dominoes and card games, and then us having kids at the same time, she was still always there. Her smile and her laugh are one of a kind, and a memory that will live in my mind forever. I've always admired her, looked up to her, and wanted to be like her. She was always a hero to me. If you met her, you loved her, animal or human. She is genuinely the kindest soul you could ever know. She always made me feel seen and heard and important and most of all, loved. Cancer is a thief and I will never understand. Please pray for my Uncle Casey and cousins Emily and Cody. Please pray for my grandparents, my Aunt Julie, and my dad. Please pray for everyone who knows and loves her. Thank you, Jamie, for a lifetime of memories and love. I still want to be just like you. Thank you.
My name is Bill Bundy, and for those of you that don't know me, Dee Dee and I, my wife and I, moved to Graham in 2012, and the Eppersons were one of the first families we got to know. I'm not a preacher. Everybody knows Dorman. Everybody knows John, so I thought I probably should introduce myself. Just a guy that really loved the Eppersons, that really loved Jamie and Cody and Emily and Don and LaVon. Just love them. Jamie was my dentist, but that's not how our relationship started. Actually, it started, as Dorman talked about, this class she did, Run for God. And I was in that class. And actually, I really kind of thought I was the only guy in that class. I don't remember any other guys being in that class. But I think Jamie taught it, Nellie helped her co-teach it, and it kind of culminated in this run that Dorman was talking about in Breckenridge. this 5K run, and I ran in that 5K run. And just like kind of Dee Dee and I always do, we after it was over, we headed back to Graham. You know, I didn't think anything about it. That afternoon, Jamie shows up at our house, and she brings me a medal. And she tells me, you won for your age classification, the 5K run. And I started kind of puffing up and saying, well, you know, Jamie, I was a pretty good athlete when I was in school. That shouldn't be any surprise to anybody. All right. And she pretty quickly shut that down. She said, well, we'll just keep it between us, Bill, that it was you and two older women that were in your age classification. So what I can tell Jamie now is I have done that. I have kept that between us until right now. But it was great, that's just kind of the way she was. And then she became my dentist in I just remember one appointment where I was in, and I was having problems with a tooth. It wasn't for a cleaning this time. It was actually for a problem. And when you got problems, Jamie would have kind of sharp objects, you know, that she would kind of prod around into your mouth. And as I was in the dentist chair, mouth wide open, she starts talking to me. She says, Bill, I've got some ideas that I would really like for you to go, you know, maybe let's go have lunch together sometime and we can kind of talk about these ideas. And I think she was pretty confident with my mouth wide open and that sharp object in my mouth. I was going to say yes to that, which I did. And we met at Neary's. All right, about a week or two later, and I remember sitting there wondering, you know, what is it that she wants to talk about? And really it was her conception of this Spivey, the 5K run, the Spivey Hill Challenge. You know, and I can remember she brought notes. She started thinking, I want to take notes. Well, she went through everything she had planned. I mean, she had this thing planned to a T already. All right. And all I did was say, hey, that sounds good. Hey, that sounds good. Hey, that sounds good. You know, and after that first Spivey Hill challenge, I will never forget Jamie just outside after church service one Sunday, just coming up and hugging me and saying, thank you so much for all your help. And I'm like, Jamie, I didn't do anything. You know, number one, I came up with no ideas. All right, all I did was agree with everything. And she said, you did so much because you never discouraged me from doing it. You were always positive about me doing it. I encouraged you doing that. And she just had a way of making you feel like you were something else, you know, that you were special, that you were a great person, and that, you know, the things that she was going to do, that you had something to do with it. And, man, she was just, and I don't know how, that's a gift. That's a gift that God gives. She was the most positive person I've ever met in my life. I asked my wife, I said, Dee Dee, I said, if you were going to describe Jamie in one word, what would you say? And she says, positive. You know, she was. She was the most positive person that there ever was. And I've always wished, you know, sometimes why don't you ask some of these questions to people? You know, how do you stay so, how do you smile all the time, Jamie? You know, other than being a dentist, why would you smile all the time, you know? And I don't know, I never got a chance to ask her, but I really think Jamie would say, you know what, Bill, I think I understand what Jesus meant in John 10 when he talked about this life, giving us life and giving us life abundant. And I think she knew it really wasn't about being, it wasn't about being wealthy, it wasn't about being healthy, and it wasn't about living the American dream. I think she understood that the life abundant that Jesus promised us is a life that gives us the advantage that we crush Satan. I mean, we just crush his head because we got God's spirit in us. And Jamie, because of that, never looked back. I mean, Jamie was always, she was looking forward for what the next great adventure was going to be, and she was looking up for what God was going to do with her. I don't know that she had a rearview mirror. She had to drive with one maybe, but in her life she didn't look back, folks. Man, she was always looking forward and looking ahead. And that was just tremendous. Great example. I loved it. And Don and LaVon, I mean, I just got to say thank you for bringing such a wonderful lady into this world. And for raising her and letting her spread her wings and look at the people she touched. Look at the lives that she's impacted. Look at the great things that have happened because Jamie was in this world. And Emily and Cody, it is tough right now to think about what a blessing. But man, what a blessing she was. And I'm going to tell you right now, until the day you die, she will always, always be a blessing to you. Always. And Casey, I don't know how you got her to say yes. But that was a great day. That was a great day. And because she said yes, the Eppersons became a great team, became a great family, and did great things together. And I know all of these things that Jamie, I remember riding with you on that golf cart, picking up all the pylons, you know, after the Spivey Hill Challenge. I mean, I know all of those things. Man, y'all melded together and were a great team. We're a great example to Cody and Emily about what a family should be, about how you should work together, you know, and about being a great husband and a great wife. And I just want to thank you for that encouragement and all the things that you've done. And of all the things, Jamie, I really don't know what you're experiencing right now. You know, I don't know if Jesus has come up to you with that great sparkling towel that I kind of dream of and, you know, grabbed you and hugged you and said, hey, let me get my blood off of you before I introduce you to my dad. You know, and then you walk out and there's confetti cannons going off, and I mean, there's bands playing and there are these great celebrations. I don't know. I don't know what it's like. You know, I can only imagine. I can only imagine. And I probably, to be honest with you, can't even imagine. But the one thing I do know, is Jamie, you are perfect now. And everything around you is perfect. And for that, we are so grateful and so thankful. And enjoy that perfection that you've well deserved. We love you so much. And God, we thank you for giving us this lady, Jamie. We thank you so much for allowing our paths to cross. And we love the Eppersons and we love the Reeves. And as John said, man, there's a lot of love in this room. Lean on it. Lean on it as much as you need to, because these folks want to be with you and support you. And Jamie will be greatly missed, but her spirit will live on. Thank you.
If it's convenient for you and you're able, would you be standing for this song?
How great the chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your
as long.
Satan's grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living home.
Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your merry body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declared, the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, yours is the
Beautiful thoughts this morning. Beautiful. I want to begin this morning with my part by asking you, do you know why you're here? And no, it's not because Jamie died with cancer. Do you know why you're here? I'll tell you why you're here. Because Don and LaVon got Jay and Julie and Jamie together one day when they were living up out in the panhandle of West Texas. And Don said, look, I've got enough money where we can go on one vacation to Hawaii. Or we could get us a place on Possum Kingdom. I guess that's back in the day when you could afford a place on Possum Kingdom. He said, we can get us a small place on Possum Kingdom and we can go to that lake anytime we want to go. And they all got together. I don't know who was the persuasive one, but somebody in that family said, let's do it. And they all followed suit. And they got him a little place at PK. That's how Jamie came to love Graham. And she was looking for a place like this when she finished dental school. I'll tell you another reason why you're here today. I'll tell you another reason why you're all friends with Jamie and Casey and all the families. Because Dr. Scott one day had a lot of patients. His office was a little bit chaotic. And there was this man named Bill Gregory, who was a family friend of Don and LaVon, and he was there at his office to get some dental work done, and he said, Dr. Scott, looks like you need some help around here. And Dr. Scott, in a moment of humility, said, yeah, I sure do. And he goes, well, it just so happens I've got some really good friends, and their daughter is about to graduate dental school from the University of Texas at San Antonio. Would you like for me to see if she might be interested in coming and helping you? And Dr. Scott was like, absolutely, that would be wonderful. And so sure enough, Jamie does give Dr. Scott a call, and they make a relationship, and she signs a contract to work with him for 5 years. And when the contract was over, she was going to sign a contract for another 5 years. And Dr. Scott says, well, Jamie, why don't you just buy the practice? And so that's how Jamie came to Graham, and that's how Jamie came into that practice. And there's one more part of the story. Jamie was working out at Body Works. I don't know if y'all were around when it was called Body Works. And Casey was working out at that time. Doesn't look like you've been there in a while, Casey, but nevertheless. He was a young, good-looking guy at the time. And y'all, when in a small town, when a beautiful young lady shows up that nobody really knows, I don't know what the ladies are thinking, but the guys are like, oh, who is that? And Casey was brave enough to ask some dude named Spencer, who I'm told is a loudmouth. Now, I don't, Spencer, if you're here, I'm just telling you like it is. But anyway, Spencer was there working out with Casey, and Casey says, who is that girl over there? Oh, you don't know Reeve? And he said it just like that. Like everybody in Body Works heard him yell out, oh, you don't know Reeve? Come here, let me introduce you to Reeve. And so he takes Casey over to meet Jamie. Jamie's doing some setups, and that's how Casey and Jamie met. 2 years later, they went out on their first date. It took Casey 2 years. 2 years to convince her to go out with him. But anyway, y'all, Casey, there is a theme that emerged in all the conversations that I have. It seems like you're slow. I don't know if that's the case or not. And I'll demonstrate that with the next story. So it was June of 2000. They had been dating for a while, and they went to someone's wedding. It was a beautiful wedding. It was very romantic. And they're on their way back together from this wedding. They've been dating for a while. And on the way home, Jamie says to Casey, well, when are we going to get married? Well, Casey, being the wisecrack that he is, goes, well, when, I guess whenever you ask me. And Jamie said, will you marry me? And Casey said, oh my gosh, I guess I'm getting married. Anyway, next thing he knows, they're booking a venue in Lake Tahoe, and that's how they ended up getting married. So there you go, Emily, Cody, that's your story, man. You got a lot of people to be grateful for, because, you know, isn't it beautiful, like when you hear the stories, and you know, there's a silent partner that's in the background, and it is Almighty God, and he just makes the story beautiful. And then, of course, you know, Jamie has the practice with Dr. Scott and all of her staff. You all have been so blessed by being around this amazing person. Just a few things this morning. We got to celebrate her life. Give glory to who glory is due. Give honor to who honor is due. So there's a few things I just have to say in celebration of Jamie Epperson. First of all, there was never a laugh before and will never be a laugh again like Jamie Epperson's laugh. Casey was telling me about how easy it was to find her when he would go shopping at Walmart. Y'all know when we go shopping, we separate and go our different ways. We just shoot our spouse or friend a text, where are you, meet me up front. All Casey had to do is just stop and listen, and Jamie's laugh would be heard. Oh, she's 5 miles over. And he could easily locate Jamie. I had such a precious time. I mean, just an amazing time speaking with Jamie's staff and coworkers the other day. And Suzanne told me a story about she was working on a patient, and you could hear Jamie just cackling and laughing and cutting up and going on. And whoever Suzanne was working on looked up at Suzanne and was like, she's not like that all the time, right? They're like, that can't be real. And Suzanne's like, well, you don't know Jamie. That's real. That's Jamie. That's just who she is. Beautiful laugh. Beautiful smile. Somebody described from Eastside, somebody described Jamie's smile as a megawatt smile. It just radiated light. Just radiates light. So beautiful. If you were a friend of Jamie, and by the way, who wasn't? You had a friend that was non-judgmental, that was not critical, that was someone who listened. You know, Bible teaches us wisdom. Be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to become angry. Jamie was all of the... There's a passage in the book of James, James chapter 1, verse 5, that says, if any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God. And listen, here's what's so beautiful about this text. Who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. Isn't that beautiful? like you would think, we're not open to people that we feel threatened about. And here's Almighty God saying, ask me for anything. I'll be glad to listen. And so people all the time, when they had something they were trying to work through and just wanted a friend to listen to, Jamie was that person to help them just kind of discover the best path to take in life. What a great friend. Amen. At Eastside, we say amen. When I say amen with a question mark, that means you respond with amen. Like we're all in agreement. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Oh, y'all are good. Y'all come Sunday. I could feed off that. It could be a long sermon. Another thing that I want to point out for Jamie is just the influence for good, which has already been the Bill's tribute and all the tributes today from Dorman and from the niece and the nephew. It's just beautiful. When I was talking to the office staff the other day, I asked one of them, I said, well, how long have you been working for Jamie? And I think it was Suzanne, and she said 14 years. And then I was like, well, how long have you worked? And the next one, Karen said, well, I worked 19 years. And then Angela said, I've been here for 25 years. And Rachel said, I've been here for 22. Melinda was 24, and JC was 18. And Cecilia, a year and a half. She's the newbie. And then Chrissy's been there almost 30 years. And I just paused for just a moment. I go, what do y'all make of that? Like, there's a story behind that, right? Y'all understand leadership. Jamie was a leader. Now, some leaders lead by authority. You just do it because I'm in a position of power, and when I say it, you do it. Now, she might have done that from time to time. Maybe the bamboo toothbrushes that they had y'all put in the swag bag, she forced that on y'all. No, but okay, I got that. That's a place of authority. Okay, we'll just go along with Jamie. We'll pay three times more than what a plastic brush, but if it makes Jamie happy, it makes us happy too, right? So positional authority, that's some leadership, but then some leadership comes, and this is the greatest leadership. It comes from life and character. Follow me as they demonstrate what it is that they want to do. It's by their character and their life. And let me tell you what, Jamie was a giver. One of the office staff was telling me a story about when she first started working with Jamie, and she had a family relative, the staff member had a family relative that had passed away. And no one was able to buy the spray of flowers that would go on top of the casket. And y'all know how hard it is when you really need some financial help. And it's like, who could I talk to that would maybe help me out through this spot? So she goes up to Jamie, and Jamie's like, well, sure, how much is it? $700. So she gave her the money. She says, Jamie, I'm going to pay you back. And anyway, when she was able to pay Jamie back, she tried to pay Jamie back, and Jamie just wouldn't take it. I mean, that's just who she was. And Dorman's right, you know, people on Saturday evening or Sunday evening or whenever, they got their teeth knocked out playing ball here in Graham or something, all those emergencies. I did find out later on that they stopped calling Jamie when they had an emergency. They would call Casey. And Casey's like, well, here she is, you know, and hand her the phone. And then Casey would go and help her and run Mr. Slurpee. It's good stuff, man. It's good stuff. The staff told me during all that debacle with COVID-19, when everybody wasn't able to go to work, they weren't in the office for about 7 weeks. And Jamie paid for them, even though they weren't working. Now, I have a word for that. It's called loyalty. And I'll tell you, if I had a boss like that, I'll be there. You just, whatever you want, whenever you want it. You love me, I love you. Man, in the world is a beautiful place. Amen?
Amen.
See, y'all are getting good now. Jamie was a leader, but following her lead could make life interesting. Like Jody, is it Dacus? Dacus. Jody was telling me a story about how Jamie had convinced all these ladies like Zan Hollab and Susan Davidson and Jody and all of them to start running. They had just started running training for a 5K. Jamie had already signed them up for a half marathon. That's kind of ambitious. And they did it, you know, they did it. And when they were practicing one day, I believe it was in Jacksboro at a state park, They were all running and working out. This was a Sunday afternoon, I believe it was, or evening, and they're running, and Jamie was a little slower than the others, but she was determined. And anyway, I was told that there was a pit bull or some kind of vicious dog that was near there, and Jamie kept trying to be sweet and nice to this dog. It was behind a fence. Well, the dog broke through the fence and took off chasing her, and she was running, and the dog bit her on the back of her leg on the Achilles heel. And so anyway, the others got back to the car. They'd finished. They're like, where's Jamie? Is she ever going to show up? Finally, Jamie comes hobbling up, and she's got blood running down the back of her leg. And they're like, what happened? And she's like, well, this dog bit me. And they're like, a dog bit you? We need to tell the police. No, we're not going to call the police. And then one of them said, we just need to get a gun and shoot that thing. And she's like, no, Jamie, it really needs to be turned in. We need to find out if that dog has rabies and on. And she's like, no, because she knew if it got turned in, it would be taken away. And if it got taken away, it'd probably be euthanized. And Jamie could not deal with that. So she got her way. She always gets her way. Amen? Like the Christmas float idea? When the office and all of them had to put together the Christmas float, and y'all know what the theme song was for the Christmas parade here in Graham for the dental group. Their theme song was, all I want for Christmas is my... And so she got black electrical tape and made them all put black electrical tape to create that gap on the front. While she wears the sequined, shiny Santa suit, everybody else is donned in black electrical tape. But anyway, it was good stuff. They won first place. Good job, guys. Good job. That was beautiful. And of course, the cruises and the trips, right, Casey? Where she weighed her influence upon you. Casey, there's three ways to travel. By land, by air, and by sea. Two of the three Casey does not like. Guess which two? Casey, let's go on a cruise. No, I don't want to go on a cruise. No, we're going to go on a cruise. No, I don't want to go on a cruise. Okay, I'll go on the cruise. I think David and Melinda was with them. Melinda told me it was the worst weather you could possibly imagine while they're out there on the cruise. Casey's throwing his guts up, can't get out of the cabin. Jamie and David and Melinda, they just go on and have a good time. Every now and then Jamie would check on Casey. He's all right, y'all, let's go have fun. Meanwhile, he's in the floor begging Jamie, just send a helicopter. Have him send a helicopter. Just get me off of this boat now. And anyway, they stopped at a port, so I'm told. And at this port, of course, there's land. We can get back on land. And at this port, they had bought tickets to swim with the dolphins. Does that sound like Jamie Epperson? We're going to swim with the dolphins. $150 a ticket to swim with the... And so everybody had a ticket, including Casey. And Casey's like, I ain't getting in that water. I'm not going. I'm staying right here on this bench between these two old ladies. They actually have a picture of Casey being left behind, sitting beside two old ladies while they go all have fun, so... It's great, man. It's great. This is great. Y'all had so many stories. I wish I could tell them all. They're just awesome. You just got to spend time with the family. I sincerely, I'll say this to you. Jamie was one of the, Mindy and I moved here 2 years ago. We're newbies to Graham. And Jamie was one of the first ladies to really connect with my wife, Mindy. And the first time they went and met at that coffee bar down the street or whatever, they spent 3 hours just talking. My wife's a talker and Jamie's talking. That's 3 hours. That's probably just getting started right there. And Mindy came home going, I can't wait to get to know Casey and Jamie. I think they're going to be great friends of ours. But, Jamie was already battling cancer. And between family and work and battling cancer, there just wasn't much left. But I just got to watch and stand on the sideline and see a hero just emerge, another hero for me in my life. And anyway, I just wanted to say that, my friend. But we are going duck hunting this fall. The other thing that I'd love to say is just, Emily and Cody, you guys, you were wanted How many miscarriages? I don't even know. 3 miscarriages. She desperately wanted you. And you are loved. Now, I want you to hear what I'm about to say in context and in the right way. I want this to be taken, because it could potentially upset you, but I want you to hear me clearly. You'll get it later on in life. It is better to have been loved and to have lost what you have lost than to have never known that love before. If you want to say amen, you can. Amen. Right? There are millions of people, young children, on the face of this earth that have not known love like you. Let that just bless you. And I tell you what, if you'll smile and laugh and love contagiously like Jamie did, you will find the joy that she knew here. It is beautiful what Jesus said, and I try to tell people, like, whatever's missing in your life, just give it away. Literally. If you want friendship, give it away. If you want love, give it away. If you want hope, share it. I mean, just give, give, give. You never run out of this stuff, and then the next thing you know, you look around, and you're surrounded by more love than you could ever imagine. The other thing that I just want to point out, just in my closing thoughts, this right here is a treasure. I asked Casey the other day, I was like, did Jamie have like a little devotional Bible, something she might have marked in or wrote little notes in the column or whatever? Oh, yeah. It's like, can you bring that by? And I want to keep it until after the service. And so, y'all, I got this Bible and I opened it up Wednesday and I went from Genesis to Revelation. And I just read one note and where she underlined and what her little reflections that she wrote. I spent 2.5 hours reading her, not the word, but the reflections of Jamie on the word. If you ever want to know what's in your mom's heart and what was on the mind and why she is the person that she is, you will find it in here. This is a treasure. I want to share just a couple of them. There was a section about the story of Samson, strongest guy in the Bible. She wrote this. Great strength in one area of life doesn't make up for weakness in others. The book of Ruth, which is a book of tragedy and triumph, she wrote this to summarize the book of Ruth. Ruth's life exhibited admirable qualities. She was consistently hardworking, loving, kind, faithful, and brave. I read that, Jay, and I'm like, where have we seen that before? She embodied that. There was a story about Israel and the Ark of the Covenant that had been taken away, and then the Philistines sent it back, and she had wrote a little comment. She said, don't just be sorry. Too often we complain to God while we refuse to act. Change. Do what he requires. I love this comment on Nehemiah. It was a summary of the book of Nehemiah. Don't just complain about the world's problems. Do something. I mean, y'all are sharing stories about all these things that she did. There you go. This was good. Psalm 112, she wrote at the top. This is awesome. She goes, fear of God equals fearless life. Right? So putting God first, you know, like have you ever like buttoned up your shirt one morning and you get you started with the wrong button and then the rest of the shirt's all mangled or whatever? You know, if you get the first button right, all the other buttons fit. You know, what's the first command? Love the Lord your God. And the second one's like, love your neighbor as yourself. Wow. And I got to read you Revelation, the very last part of the very last book of the Bible, very last chapter. Here was. Y'all see that? I know you can't read it, but can you see the little comment at the bottom? Here it is. Genesis describes Adam and Eve walking and talking with God. Revelation describes people worshiping God face to face. Revelation is a book of hope. It shows that no matter what happens on earth, God is in control. It promises that evil will not last forever. And it depicts the wonderful reward that is waiting for all those who believe in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. right? I have a friend back in Abilene. He wrote a summary of Revelation. And it's really a summary of the gospel. It's a summary of the whole story of God. And it's like, and this is it, and I'll share it with you guys and kind of wrap it up here. It's like, God has a team, and Satan has a team. God's team wins. Pick a team. Jamie picked Team Jesus, right? That's what the cross is all about, that we can pick Team Jesus. Jamie was awesome. She wasn't perfect. She was a horrible driver. I'll be the one to say it. Y'all know it. I got stories, but I'm not going to share them. Miss Miller, who was Emily's kindergarten teacher, was putting together a big Thanksgiving party, and Jamie volunteered to bring a dessert, and so she went to United and bought a pumpkin pie, and she took it to the class, and a little while later, Miss Miller called her, and she says, "Jamie, the pie is raw. It has to be cooked." So from then on, Jamie was the mom who supplied the plates and the napkins and cups. Oh, and there is the time she slapped Cody in the face when he was 8 years old. We've never seen Jamie angry, have we? She's always composed and in control, but Cody pushed all of her buttons one day. Real fidgety one day in the restaurant there, and he grabbed Jamie's hand and was loving on her hand. Then he decided to squeeze her hand, and she was wearing all these rings, and it hurt her fingers, and she popped him. So then Casey, always when Cody was getting out of line, from then on, he's like, "Hey, boy, that mom will slap you now." Oh, man. Jesus says, "Let your light shine, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." Jamie's glorified you, Father. I'm going to close with this. I don't want to close, but I am. This is from 1 Corinthians 13. I always use this when I'm marrying people, and this is that love chapter. I always quote this: love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It's not proud. By the way, this is the way to freedom, folks. Here it is. It's not proud. It doesn't dishonor others. It's not self-seeking. It's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. My favorite line: love never fails. It's been some rough days for the past 2 years. Julie, your love for your sister never failed. Jay, your love for your sister never failed. Don, your love for your daughter never failed. LaVon, never failed. Emily, she was so proud when you went to school in the midst of her battle. You did not fail her. She is so proud of you. Casey, Cody, your love never failed. Faithful, loyal to the end. There's this story. I'm going to close with this. I believe it's Luke 18. Jesus is in, he's making his way to Jerusalem. That's where he's going to die for all of us. And he's approaching Jericho. There's this blind man who was there on the way, and he heard all the commotion, and he yelled out to somebody like, what is it? What's going on? And somebody said, it's Jesus of Nazareth. And so he yelled out, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Like, he didn't say Jesus of Nazareth. He said, Jesus, son of David. Oh, he recognized Jesus for who he was. He is the son of David. He is the true Messiah, the King, the Christ. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. And he kept saying it. People kept rebuking him to be quiet. And Jesus stopped in his little entourage there. And he stopped and he yelled for the man to come to him. And so they brought the man to him, and he says to the man, "What is it that you want?" And he said, "Jesus, I want to see." And Jesus healed the man. And he was blind. And the first one that he saw was his healer and Savior, Jesus. Y'all, I kept praying for a miracle. I ain't ashamed to say it. I kept praying to all of you. Casey's mom said it best. "John, I don't know what we're going to do." You know, Miss Sherry, she's like, "I'm so upset about this." And she began to tell me, and then she was like, I've prayed till I puked. And if y'all know Sherry, that sounds just like Sherry. "I prayed till I puked." And I'm like, and I'm going to tell you, that stuck in my heart. I'm like, what you just said, Miss Sherry, boy, it could not have been said better. We prayed till we puked. And we did not get our miracle here on earth. But Jamie did get the miracle of heaven. And the first one she saw was Jesus.
Okay, I wanted to make this short little video while I'm walking, while I'm thinking. And I want to say, I've already forgotten what I want to say. I want to say thank you to God for helping me to begin to feel normal again. This journey I'm on, I don't know where it's going to take me, but I do know that whatever it is, I'm going to be a winner. I'm going to win because God is on my side, and I can do all things through God, Christ, who strengthens me. Whatever happens, love will win, Christ will win. And I'm going to live my life and be normal. I want to encourage all of you to count your blessings now. I want to encourage all of you to evaluate your health and to take steps to be healthy. Get outside, get some vitamin D, get some time alone with your thoughts, with God. Eat healthy, eat plants, drink water, and just take advantage of all the beauty and the gifts God has given us. Okay, I wanted to make...
Jamie gets the last word. As we close and we get ready to leave this place, I want to leave you with the blessing of the Lord. Now may the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will. And may he work in us what is pleasing to him through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.